And after the palace, we walked to the Olympic Park. And it was kind of funny because Bon Jovi was actually there, surprisingly, like, what the heck? Bon Jovi's there. So people were everywhere, everywhere. And we could hear them, like, warming up in the big stadium, just getting stuff ready for that night. And, yeah, so that's a beautiful place. It's always cool seeing the Olympic stuff. Then after that, we walked all the way across Munich to Das Biergarten, right here, which, beautiful park, huge just beer gardens, people drinking again. Like, you really can't deny the German beer culture. I'm just saying that. we actually met a friend from Frankfurt, from Viadrina here, and yeah, hung out there for a bit, and later that evening, we just kind of walked back. No, wait. We took the U-Bahn, we took the subway back. So we didn't walk everywhere in Munich, but yeah. So that was Munich. It's very interesting compared to Berlin. It's cleaner. Like, Berlin has like a grittiness, like East Germany, like still kind of reserved about the war and reserved about the wall and just kind of not as friendly. I think like the best word I keep on like coming to my mind is like gritty. Berlin's gritty and Munich is like clean and pretty and like, I don't know, I just picture like biker bros and like gangsters in Berlin. And then when I think of Munich, I think of like guys in like lederhosen and then the like all the pretty girls in the dirndls or dirndls, I don't know what they're called, but the pretty dresses, like, it's just so much different. And then Sunday, we went to Füssen early in the morning, which is right outside of Neuschwanstein Castle. And so we checked into Füssen, and then we went to the castle and walked around, walked up the mountain, and that place, wow. Like, you see pictures when you're a kid, you watch Disney, anything Disney. That's where Disney got the idea for his castle. Beautiful. We got there, it was foggy, it was cloudy, so it kind of looked like a haunted castle, I guess. And then we got to the top of the mountain and then it cleared away, like, just magically. There's no more clouds and you could see like over Germany, you could see Austria, you could see the castle down below, you could see the Alps, like snow and stuff. It was just, ooh, it was awesome. Yeah, I definitely want to go back there sometime. Yeah, and Monday, since we didn't plan anything out very well, we had to leave early because of the holiday. Like, they actually celebrate Pentecost here, so that's what was going on Monday, holiday. So this bus thing wasn't going, so we didn't want to pay the Deutsche. We didn't want to take the train all the way back to Berlin because it would be super expensive. So we checked the carpooling thing again to ride with some random bro again. And turns out the only thing that we could find was out of Nuremberg. And that was at 1 p.m. So we leave Füssen like 7 a.m. I think. 8 a.m. Something really early we leave Füssen. So we didn't get to go inside the castle. That kind of bummed us out. But so we get to go from Füssen to Munich, and then we go from Munich to Nuremberg, and the guy bro calls us and says he can't leave until like 4:30, something weird. So we have like 5 hours to kill in Nuremberg, so we just kind of walk around again, and we actually go back to the beer fest and get a couple more steins because Kevin didn't get one, so we got one for him and just had another beer, and then went back to Nuremberg and then met the guy, and we actually drove in a Mercedes, but it was a huge van. We actually rode with 9 other people. I got a hold of baby on the way back. What the heck? Yeah, so I end up getting back to Frankfurt like 10:30 that night, so it was just like all day traveling, but yeah, worth it, definitely. So to wrap this up, I will probably just say my three favorite things, and yeah, so number one, the people, the culture, and the vibes that just different between here, East Germany, and West Germany. Like, they're friendly, they're patriotic, yeah, everything's older. So this is my number two, actually. The architecture and the old stuff, like, it's just cool seeing stuff that wasn't blown up, wasn't bombed, and just has like more German feel to it. And lastly, number three, the castles and nature of Bavaria. Like, because the farther south you go, you just start getting into the hills, and then you get into the little mountains, and then you get into the Alps, and of course, Neuschwanstein was incredible. Yeah. So normally, I guess I'd do my least three favorite things, I guess. But honestly, I can't think of anything I didn't like. Like, pretty sure my ha like half my heart is there. Like, I just left it. So would I recommend going to Bavaria? Definitely in a heartbeat. Would I go back, and will I go back later? Hopefully. Yeah, I just want to go back as soon as possible. Like, that place is incredible. So yeah, this video is wrapping up. I will let you know, I guess, on social media, Twitter, Facebook, on where I'm going next. We have finals next week, so I've kind of been studying. This week's been really boring. Yeah, but big plans ahead. I'm gonna go somewhere crazy. So yeah, just watch my stuff, and you'll know where I go next. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.